Okay, next is IT in transportation. Transportation is vital to our society proper functioning, providing mobility of people, goods and services. Okay, so transportation ni melibatkan kita seharian lah, pergerakan kita seharian. Bukan kita sahaja tapi barang-barang. Okay, bila kita order barang semua. It enables people to assess job markets and participate in recreational, cultural, educational and social activities. You nak pergi kerja, you nak pergi campus, okay, you nak buat aktiviti sosial, semua melibatkan transportation. So the transportation field also is a major contributor to the economy as a consumer of resources and as a supplier of job. Okay, so transportation field ni menyediakan pekerjaan juga, satu pekerjaan kepada pemandu bas ke dan sebagainya. Okay, dan dia juga merupakan satu sumber kepada kita dan penggerak kepada ekonomi. IT especially in light of emerging information technology is fundamental to the transportation. So the Internet of Things assume that all people and items can be connected through networks. This vast connected network could potentially influence many aspects of our daily driving. Okay, contohnya penggunaan IoT tadi dalam transportation, route planning, salah satunya route planning. So sensors in the vehicle communicate with GPS services to determine the best route. Okay, contoh kita on GPS, kalau kita dengar ada satu kemalangan di satu jalan, kita nak lalu jalan tu dan kita dengar traffic jam teruk. Okay, kita on GPS dan kita boleh search for best route. Dia akan tunjukkan kita alternatif route, jalan alternatif, which is then displayed on a head-up display that physically direct the driver along the route. And then accident prevention, okay, sensors alert drivers to the position of other vehicles on the road and prevent collision. Okay, kita boleh detect, okay, kat mana kejadian kemalangan. So the cars can even override driver controls to avoid an accident. Safety, a series of sensors in the seatbelt can track the driver's physiological indicators and determine whether the driver is fatigued or intoxicated. If the driver fails any of the tests performed by the sensors, the vehicle become inoperable. Okay, ini dibagi contoh lah. Okay, penggunaan IoT dalam transportation. Okay, if you refer to this figure, transportation efficiency, lower operating cost, improve safety. Ini adalah tiga aspek bila kita ada IT dalam transportation. Okay, transportation efficiency, contohnya connected vehicles and smart roadways provide real-time traffic, transit and parking data for maximum efficiency and minimum congestion. Okay, contohnya kalau melibatkan IoT dan transportation, kita nak pergi park kereta, kalau dia ada elemen of smart parking, dia boleh detect. Okay, berapa lagi kekosongan? Okay, biasanya kalau kita nak masuk satu tempat parking tu, ada orang yang jaga, kata dah full ke, boleh masuk lagi ke. Tapi kalau sistem tu menggunakan smart parking, dia boleh detect automatically. Okay, bila ada parking kosong, barulah dia buka palang tu. Kalau tak, dia akan tutup. Dan dia boleh show kat mana ada kekosongan untuk kita park. Then, contoh kedua, lower operating cost. Operating data and diagnostic drive preventive maintenance to decrease cost and improve warranty service processes. Improve safety, vehicles talking to each other, enable cooperative crash avoidance safety applications. Okay. So IoT ni kita boleh monitor average speed. Okay, kalau dekat kenderaan awam, okay, mungkin ada sensor yang boleh mengawal, boleh monitor kelajuan yang dibawa oleh pemandu. Okay, berapa pressure tayar dia, okay, kelembapan dalam transport tu, contoh kalau dia bawa barang yang mudah rosak, okay, dan sebagainya lah. Kita boleh tengok dekat sini. Okay, and the advent of self-driving cars such as the Google car and Tesla are making the idea of autonomous cars a reality. However, the safety and public acceptance of these autonomous vehicles has been a question of public interest and concern. Okay, contohnya self-driving cars. Okay, tapi ni masih lagi still under research. Okay, sebab dia melibatkan isu keselamatan awam. Moreover, a series of accidents in the summer of 2016 increased the debate about the safety of autonomous vehicles. Okay, contohnya macam LRT, dia boleh bergerak sendiri. Okay, tapi still ada human intervention sebenarnya. If it is successfully implemented, it has both economic and environmental benefit. Removing human control from the vehicle will potentially help cars reach their design fuel economy, leading to less gas consumption and reduce cost of vehicle ownership. Okay, ni antara kebaikan ni lah. Okay, getting a ticket for bus, airplane, any mode of transportation make easier as there are lots of online ticket booking services. Okay, online ticket booking services juga salah satu elemen IT in transportation. Making use of IT is a smart way of getting the ticket earlier than others who decided to buy it directly from the seller from the sellers. Okay, kalau dulu orang nak beli tiket bus, tiket flight, perlu pergi dekat kalau nak beli tiket flight perlu pergi ke airport, kalau nak beli tiket bus perlu pergi dekat stesen bus. Tapi sekarang ni orang boleh beli secara online. So several features provided in the service are customers can easily choose their time and seat based on their preference, selecting add-ons provided which make it easy to plan their trips. Okay, kita boleh pilih masa, nak pilih seat mana dan sebagainya. So on-demand ride service or e-hail service such as Uber, Grab dynamically change the way people in large cities find transportation. Macam dulu nak tunggu taksi, kena tunggu tepi jalan, okay, lambai-lambai. But now we have, kalau kita biasa kita ada Uber, ada Grab. Okay, sebelum tu My Taxi. With an app, riders can summon a vehicle to their location at any time they want it. The services have already eroded the profits of cab companies and decreased DOI rates in many cities. While on-demand ride services are ahead with riders, there are serious legal and ethical questions that are causing government to re-evaluate authorization for Uber and Lyft. Yang ni mungkin dekat negara luar ni, to work in their jurisdictions. Okay, walaupun begitu, still ada isu keselamatan. Okay, contohnya betul ke pemandu terbawa customer ke tempat yang sepatutnya. Okay, dan ada juga isu-isu macam jenayah yang dilakukan oleh driver ataupun customer terhadap driver. So the primary concern is that Uber and Lyft drivers are considered contract earners and not employees, leaving them with the burden of income tax but few benefits. Okay. The most ambitious of all of the technologies in transportation is SpaceX Hyperloop. The concept is pneumatic cube that use a series of linear induction motors and compressors to propel vehicles at super fast speed. Okay, ni dekat negara luar lah. The first proposed Hyperloop would connect Los Angeles and San Francisco and allow passengers to complete the 350-mile okay, trip in just more than half an hour. Okay, ni contoh IT in transportation dekat negara luar. Okay, yang boleh bergerak sangat pantas 563 km. Okay, dalam masa lebih kurang setengah jam. Time will tell if the Hyperloop technology will be the future of long distance travel in the US and eventually in the whole world. Okay. Next is IT in financial institution. So new technology and innovation that aim to compete with traditional financial method, it changed the way the bank conduct its business. Okay, one of them is ATM, automated teller machine, telecommunication devices that enable customers of financial institution to perform cash withdrawals, deposit, transfer fund and obtaining account information. Okay, kalau teman-teman dulu orang nak transfer duit untuk anak dia, perlu pergi ke pejabat pos. Okay. Tapi sekarang ni boleh pergi buat sendiri-diri ATM. Tak perlu lagi pergi dekat kaunter. Okay. Boleh masukkan cek dan sebagainya. Tak perlu lagi beratur dekat kaunter yang kat dalam. Okay. First, ATM existed in 1972 in UK. Fund might be charge to the customer using ATM service as per use. Okay. So, biasalah bila kita guna ATM, dia ada service charge dia. Okay, tahunan kalau kita tengok. Okay. Currently, most of financial institution providing its customers online or internet banking. Okay, daripada ATM, sekarang kita beralih kepada internet banking. Kita boleh transfer duit. Kalau dulu perlu pergi ATM, sekarang ni ada lagi yang lebih mudah. Boleh transfer je kalau orang tu ada online banking. Boleh transfer je melalui online. Online or internet banking is a way for customers or bank to conduct a range of financial transactions through their online banking channel. Online banking give you freedom to bank where and when you want, and is a very convenient way to stay on top of your fine. Okay, dengan adanya online banking ni, you boleh buat transfer ataupun sebarang pembayaran bil, tak kira pada bila-bila masa dan kat mana-mana je. Kalau dulu, kalau ATM, you perlu pergi dekat mesin ATM, mungkin tempat ATM tu tutup pukul 12 malam, buka pukul berapa pula, pukul 7 pagi ke. Jadi kalau online ni, you boleh buat bila-bila masa. So, these are some of the online banking services. Okay, saya rasa mostly all the banks have their own online banking services. So, typical features and function of online banking site, view accounts. Okay, you boleh monitor berapa dalam account you, gaji dah masuk ke belum. Okay, view transaction, orang transfer duit ke. Okay, transfer money between accounts, you boleh transfer duit. Okay, pay money to someone, schedule bill payments. Okay, you boleh set siap-siap. Okay, katalah bill telefon you memang RM50 je setiap bulan. You boleh schedule the payment. Okay, you boleh view statement, you boleh keluarkan summary of your transaction made per month ke. Then manage credit cards. All of these features help us in making our daily financial activity 24/7 become easier to manage. Okay, boleh buat 24 jam sehari. Okay, then on the side of the financial institution itself, managing its resources become easier as several software born from IT development supported day-to-day businesses. Okay, still lagi ada term ni, ERP is an IT system which consists of software modules that serve the need of all functional area in the financial institution. In financial institution, ERP helps speeding up the generation of management report, which also in some extent customizable, and automated. So, dengan adanya ERP ni, untuk financial institution lebih mudah bagi mereka untuk keluarkan report. Okay, mungkin report bagi company diorang dalam masa setahun, dalam masa sebulan, dan dia boleh customize mengikut report tu mengikut ke yang mereka nak lah. Okay, per customer ke, per branch ke dan sebagainya. So, it is important as it will help in making crucial decision in the institution. Okay, and the last one is IT in entertainment. Entertainment is something that holds the attention and interest of audience or give pleasure and delights. Many forms of entertainment have persisted over centuries. For example, music, film, video games and etc. Ni semua termasuk dalam hiburan lah. Okay, music, film. More types of entertainment produced from the development of technology. So, berkait rapat juga dengan teknologi sekarang ni. Video games that reached the mainstream and became popular in the late 70s and 80s is one of the main source of entertainment in the current modern culture. Okay, video game ni mula popular tahun 70s-80s. So, machine supporting the entertainment type including PC, console game. Okay, sekarang ni ada PS. Okay, PS4, Xbox dan sebagainya is common to the public. Easily accessible games such as mobile phone games also become widely popular as mobile phone is almost owned by everyone nowadays. So, sekarang ni, you boleh main game secara online dengan kawan-kawan you. Itu salah satu perkembangan. Kalau dulu kita hanya main, ajak kawan datang rumah, okay, main sama-sama. Tapi now, you can invite your friend to play online with you. Though there are limitations on running a high-end gaming which requires certain minimum requirement to run. Okay, walaupun kena pun, contohnya high-end game, mungkin dia perlu pada grafik yang tinggi ataupun internet speed yang tertentu. Okay, IT also used in movies production in such a way of achieving a visual effect that enhance the audience watching it. Okay, IT dalam entertainment juga melibatkan movie production. Okay, contohnya nak menghasilkan efek tertentu dalam filem. Okay, kita menggunakan IT. Okay, konsep green screen dan sebagainya. Okay, GUI, graphical user interface. Okay, these are enabled by video editors that are available in the market with the help of professionals with massive working hours. So, ada banyak video editors. Okay, contoh ni bagi contoh Autodesk, Motion Builder dan sebagainya. Several technology services provided by companies to the public allow them to stream movie online whether it is subscription based or free. Okay, ada juga sekarang kita boleh tengok movie secara online. Okay, streaming sama ada kita dia freely available ataupun kita perlu subscribe. Ini contohnya Netflix, iFlix dan many more. Okay, obtaining a music for your favorite artist have never been easier with the help of technology. So sekarang ni kalau nak cari lagu apa-apa, you boleh install software ataupun apps, contohnya Spotify and iTunes allow us to buy music through online without reaching out to our closest music store. Tak perlu lagi kalau zaman dulu orang pergi cari CD, pergi cari kaset. Okay, nak dengar lagu, sekarang ni boleh beli je secara online melalui apps. It has been the choice of current generation to buy the music digitally since it is much easier for them to get and manage instead of buying their physical album. Okay. Then for this question, we are going to have IT in other related fields.